Each, I want us to be both romantic lovers when we leave this building tonight. And wives, look at your husband in the eyes and respond.
I love you.
Again, the mga wives, again, iligatingo. Again. So, I love you. I love you. I want us to be both romantic lovers.
I last one, I love you. I love you. I want you tonight.
I love you. Makataluhan niyo kanya. So Psalm 118 verse 24 says, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. So this is the Lord's day. This is God's night. Tonight, we will be doing breakthroughs. We will be doing great things. And we will be doing God's work. So we will be studying the Word of God again. Ato na santunan ang Word of God. So in the minutes to come, we will be talking about God's Word. God's principles. And God's principle, they always dominate. Murul yun na siya, mo control. They will always win. So victorious, mudaog yun na ang kuan, mudaog yun ang prinsipyo sa Ginoan. It also manifests, it will show. It is always self-evident. And they go beyond ages, generations, and positions. So walay tigoang ay ani, walay batay ani, bisagun sa itong edad, ang prinsipyo sa Ginoo mapatigbabaw. So regardless as well of one's position, BBM ka, Donald Trump ka, ang kuan prinsipyo sa Ginoo mo apply gina siya. And regardless also if he's a member of Rizal Church or not, God's principle will always rule. Sa tua or sa gawas, mo rule gina siya. Now brethren, there is a time appointed for everything. There is a time to work. So we have to be very excellent with our work. Ingon ang Bible no nga we have to serve our masters with fear and trembling. So in our work, we have to put 100% no of it or to it. And then there's also a time to share the gospel. Nasa time, no? Dili na to. Kung makachance na sa to mga co-employees, then we evangelize. No? Pero dili na to. Time ngayon sa nga type-type pa dito. Nga ato na rin. No? Na time for everything. Maybe after na, maybe things ka as lunchtime or snack time. There is also a time to just sit down and rest and listen to the Word of God and be equipped, trained, and mentored. Nasaan yun na? No, panahon na ginatana. Na panahon, malingkod lang ta, listen ta, listen ta sa wali ni pastor sa Sunday. Nasa time nga we have to really work and evangelize. And we are here for God's divine appointment. It's no accident that we are here. No, maski mo niya itong number, pero kita ginang tinawag karon. No? Sila po siguro, tinawag sila nga dito lang sa sila mga balay. Kaya sinasad sila yung ministry. Nag-ministry sila mga anak. But yan, namantay ko na online. We are here for a big purpose. No? God sanctified us. God separated us. Because today we will be praying, we'll be studying His Word, and we will also be discovering His principle to know and worship Him. So brethren, marriage is like nations. Muragya pong nasod ang kaminyo. Ano? There is chaos, there is away, there is divorce, bulag, there is disappointment. If God is not in it, kung wala gani Ginoo diha, wa gina, samok gina. So in marriage also, there is chaos, there is divorce, no, there is disappointment when there is bankruptcy in the emotional love bank. So away gina, kung dili ni nato mahatag, emotional needs of the wife and the emotional needs also of the husband. And in marriage also, there is chaos, divorce, and disappointment when the love languages like words of affirmation, quality time, acts of service, gifts, and this is especially sa mga babae, need yun ni nila. So manang usay, mingin silang insensitive ka. Kaya wala na to, gipaminaw ang ilang love languages. They're very, kwan ani, very sensitive ni sila ni. So if it only falls on deaf ears. So ang ato ang kuan karon, so what we will be talking tonight is this one. Mani siya atong title. What couples need to know about God's purpose for marriage. Unsay atong dapat mahibaw-an bahin sa katuyuan sa Ginoo sa kaminyoon. A very religious 30-year-old Catholic virgin kaniminaw maniha kay gwapo ni siya nga story who profusely protested using birth control wanted a large family. She finally finds the perfect man who accepts and wholeheartedly agrees with her religious values. They marry 3 months later and were overjoyed to be blessed with healthy triplets. Sadly, her husband dies 3 years later from a heart attack. Conservative kay siya, gusto niya yamabana kay kauban rapod niya sa iyahang pagtuo. So namin niyo again siya. Nakanak sila tulo. Unfortunately, namatay. Na heart attack. So after a year of grieving, so hilaki siya. She wishes to find another husband. So ngita siya another bana. She returns to church and meets another gentleman with the same beliefs as her. They marry 3 months later, are blessed with another set of healthy triplets. So triplets na po, pila na, unom na. Sadly, her second husband dies 3 years later from a heart attack. So 3 years later, heart attack na ba? 6 years na. Ah, triplets. Again, the widow grieves for a year. Grieve na san siya. And wants to find a third husband to help her raise her family and increase her family size. Again, she finds a man who accepts her religious belief. And they marry 3 months later. Her third and longest marriage for 30 years produced 10 more children. Kanina tayo, wala na ginamatay. For 30 years, wala na. For a total of 16 kids. Daghan na kayo siyang anak. Everything is going smoothly with their marriage. Kwapo ra ilang marriage na sa 30 years. They decide to leave the kids with her mother as the couple wants to celebrate their 30th anniversary with a flight to Rome. So celebrate sa sila kay nakalingkawas. It's like 30 years. Katubi ang previous mga matay. Baya. During the flight, agoy, there is an engine failure and the plane crashes to the ground and kills everyone in the plane. Agoy, namatay pati silang doa. Mahinoy lang gikamatian. So all of the family members of the deceased attend the most beautiful and touching funeral service ever. The priest ends his sermon with, so sermon na ang pare, no, sa katong namatay, silang doa. Take heart, beloved followers, they are now together forever in heaven. Uban na sila karon sa langit. So his final remark brought all of the attendees to tears, yet made them feel glad for their departed loved ones. After the funeral, her mother, curious about the church belief, asked the priest, ang yan, mama, curious yun, mama. Sige, pasabot itong pare, no, nga. Karon, uban na sila sa langit. So, ingon niya, mama, nga, sir, father, which husband are you referencing when you said they are now together forever in heaven? Eh, di ba, tulo na ba yung bana? Oh. So, unsa man mo pasabot ato padre, nga, kinsa ka yung kauban karon? Kaya ingon ba ka nga, karon, nag-uban na sila. And then the priest replied, paminawan si tubag sa pare siya. Actually, I was talking about her legs. Wala din nakuha. Sige mo siya. Di ba sige siya kami niyo. So yahang legs. Sige siya, bikangkang. Karoon, nag-uban na giyod. Nanganak na giyod yung legs. Oh, pero diba, sige siya niyo. Triplets pa giyod. Minyo na san siya. Wala giyod pa ulay ang iyang mga legs. In a confessional, a penitent confesses to a priest, forgive me, Father, said the penitent. Diba sa Katoliko ba tayo? Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. And then the priest responded, ingon din na pari, kay nagnamay na ng umpisal, siya nga, forgive me, Father, for pasaylo ako pa din, ako'y sala, ingon din ang pari nga, ay, nagkabala ka, kabalon ako, ako na nang nabasa sa Facebook. Kani. In marriage, the husband always says the last word. Agree mo? Nga sa kaminyo on, ang banagid ang naagyoy, pinakaulahi nga ko, anagi masulti. Ang huling kuan, ang huling salita ay ang bana, ang asawa. Nga no? The last words is always, yes, dear. There are some people in marriage. Some people lang ha. Some people ani, wala niya appeal ani. Wala niya appeal. So they take marriage like going to a restaurant. So ang kami nyo on para sila murarag mga tog restaurant, no? They order what they want, order lang, eat what they want, and drink what they want. Then when they see what the other person has, makita din sila kung unsay gikaon sa lalaki sa pikas, they wish they had ordered that. So yaon, mga anak na mga mga lalaki. Kanagapangabit na. So what I'll be talking to you tonight is about what couples need to know about God's purpose for marriage. So it's about basic questions about God's intent on marriage. So our topic offers a principle-based paradigm. So this is principle-based, no? Dili ni siya gama-gama lang sa tao. But this is principle-based. It's practical. Magamit yun ni nato kada adlaw ang atong mga tips ani. It's natural. We can see this every day. Dili ni siya metaphysical. Dili ni siya binisaya. Dili po ni siya superstition. But it is Bible-based. It comes from the Bible. So as we know, the Bible is God's word. The Bible is principle. The Bible is our book of life. No, naatay mga question about life. We always go to the Bible, especially here in Resol Hub, Resol Couples Hub. We answer a question about life, speak specifically on the area of marriage through the lens of the Bible because with the Bible, we are safer. So mas mayman na sa Bible ta. mangkoan, dili, we don't base it on sa mga psychologists, psychiatrists, but we would rather go to the Bible first. With the Bible, we are right, no? In the correct position. And in the Bible also, we are in the good hands of God. So we'll be talking about God's purpose for mission. Makabasa ka diya, Sir Kuan? Sir Bong, makabasa ra ka? So what are the premises of marriage? Who created marriage? So kinsay nagbuhat sa marriage? And what is God's intention of marriage? Unsa magyud ang intention sa Ginoo sa kaminyoon? So I remember the very day of our wedding. So pagkasal na mo ni Witch, I was very confused, stressed, and scared. Which is common also among other koan, no, sa ato atanan. So, isa sa reason jud kay I don't have a very good koan. Ako mga silingan, dili gwapo ang testimony about sa marriage. No, so, hadlok sad ko maminyo dyan itong time. And another thing also, I don't have money. Wala kay kwarta. No? Pero gusto gyud ta nako, ang just like any other man's dream is I want to have an opulent wedding. Gusto ta nako nga kon ka iba kan nindot sa damo kasal ni Mitch. But that time si Pastor Chris, kailaman mo ni Pastor Chris, no, si Pastor Chris was our old koan. After kang Pastor Sunny, si Pastor Chris may nagpudi sa iya, ha? Advise us to be wed and we only have 1 month to do it or else he would be forced to remove us from ministry. Tantangon na niya sa ministry kay morag dili naman gwapo among testimony kay worker me, wa pa biya migi kasal ni Mitch. So ingon siya nga kasal na, but he said it in a loving way. Dili man siya stricto nga, kuha na mo ha, pagkasal mo na. I-advise sabi nga, sir, ganito, dapat kasal na kayo kasi, kuhaan, worker mo. Problem is, we only have 30,000 in our bank account. So, unsaon man na namo siya pag-budget. Sa may mapalit ni mo sa 30,000, ya, kaslon ka. So that budget was too small to finance our most dreamt of opulent wedding. So gamay ragit kayo ng 30,000, no? Yan ang ambisyon kag mga garden wedding, invite-on pa si Pastor Noeltan. Guest-on pa ni mong aeroplano. Mamang itong plano, gusto yun sa Bird of Light nga. Oh, imbis nga magdali, pero si Pastor Noeltan man, okay ra nga 1 year. Sa ilahaw niya, ikaw pa yung magastos sa aeroplano. So, 30,000. So, I was at a crossroad. No? I was panic, nervous, and pressed. To add to the anxiety, pag-udad to, gawas nga gamay kaya kong budget, I was also thinking of my son Noah who was in Cebu. Nga ato nga time, akong anak in town, wala ba yung isa kay Balunga, may mag-dine siya yung mama. So isa, grabe kaya ako, wala may kwarta. Maluwis ako sa bata ba na, wala para ba gibi nakaprang ka sa bata, nga wala, dili kami ang gikasal sa iya mama. Nga, mobi ato amo ang drama-drama nga, na si papa ni mo, naras Cagayan, narata diri sa Cebu, so luwi kayo. So budget plus may predicament about my son. So here comes, diri na dayon ang tabang na dayon sa mga Christian friends na mo na encouraging us. Actually, appeal sila ang Sir Ed Addo. Edgar, sila ni Ma'am Esther. Diri na dayon animo ma-value ang itong mga isuod nga Kristiyano. Encouraging us to put God first and even sharing their somewhat interesting wedding stories and how they started with zero. But then they stood to us, or they stood to what was right and how God also rewarded them for their obedience. So, in-encourage me nila, yung sila nga, dili man na problema ng kwarta, matabang raman me, niya. Isa pa kay, even gani ako, gikasal ko kay ang budget, isa sa mga Christian, mga brethren, ito nga, ikasal sila, gitiming nila, ting pamahaw, kay, gamay rin taong kailangang budget. Pamahaw, ma'am, kay, kwan lang ilang giserve, puto, suman, Nadabi kay anak storya sa imo, kitang iyaman sad sa kanang, kuan kanang, kung distribution ba sa dried mango, so, dili day ko ano. So sa una ipubli sila karon kay ning lambo sila. So guwapo ba, guwapo ng encouragement, guwapo siya nga story. So we prayed ampo mini Mitch to set September 4, 2010 to be our wedding day. So which would take only a month of planning with only 30,000 on hand. So 1 month ra gid among planning, 30,000 among budget. So but God was good. We got married that day atong September 4, 2010. In the best pagyod nga hotel sa Iligan. Gwapo nga hotel. All thanks to the contribution of the brethren. Amen. So, testimony yun ni Ana, sab. Nga gwapo kay. Ha? Ay, wala na apin si Sir Peter. Kay, kwan lagi, katungat na yun kay, kwan pabiya ko, kwan pabiya may dukatubang, kapsang mirang walo. So, nag-sponsor sa Sing Sing, na nag-sponsor sa cake, sa Litson, niya. Oh, kwarta. Let's hotel. Naka-overnight pa ni Mitch sa hotel. Nga kami pang-overnight. O, pero gitugo. So, and then, ang akong sing-sing karon, no, ang silver itom na. Na sa sabon siguro ni. Imagine, silver lang. But by God's grace, no, we were able to have a 12 years of joyful nga married life with God in the center. Pero sa bala pa namin niyo, Lord, actually, dili gid siya perfect. No? Pag kami niyo na namo, so nagid niya po yung time nga mag-away, gid me. So dili niya siya perfect. No nga, oh, gapo kaya lang kakuan, nga nani ang ilang testimony, dili gid siya perfect. Eh, there is always a time, no nga, mag-away me, nga makaanak ka nga, sus, tinood na ba ni, mauna ba gid ni siya, mauna ba gid ni akong partner, insakto ba ni akong gibuhat, did I marry the right man? Or did I marry the right woman? Insensitive ka, anamon ka na madunggan ako sa una. But the most important thing is there is always reconciliation because God just gets inside the picture solving our issues. Importante yung Ginoo, away mo pero nagi reconciliation because there is God. So our scripture reading today is from Genesis chapter 2 verses 18 to 20. Okay, let us read this all together para ma-on atong English. Okay, so Genesis chapter 2 verses 18 to 20. Okay, then the Lord God said, mabasa niya, ma'am. It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him. Now out of the ground, the Lord God had formed every beast of the field and every bird of the heavens and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all livestock and to the birds of the heavens. And to every beast of the field, but for Adam, there was not found a helper fit for him. Lord, thank you for this beautiful verse that you have given to us. Thank you, Lord, for giving us the provisions, oh Lord God, our fuel, our car, even Lord, sa among pagsakay dili sa motorella, Lord. It all came from you. It was, oh Lord God, none of it were accidental, oh Lord God. Lord, we love you, Lord. We want to know your word. We want also, oh Lord God, to excel being husbands and wives, oh Lord God. Lord, but we cannot do that, O Lord God, without you. Dili na mo ni mabuhat, Lord, kung dili ni magbarug, O Lord God, sa usa ka solid ground. And that solid ground issue. Lord, bless us. Help us, O Lord God, to understand your word. And me, Lord, speaking to these couples here, these beautiful couples here, provide for me words, O Lord God. Provide for me, O Lord God, teachings, O Lord God, that I could share with them. Thank you, Lord. All this we ask, all this we pray. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. So the average married couple, yung lukso man, kajit lang ha. Kajit lang yung gayo. So the average married couple has sex 68.5 times a year. So average, kung ano nagiday mga super couple nung everyday. Kani, ang average good kay only kuan lang. And then, the longest recorded wedding. So, kanang 68.8 times a year, that's about 5 times a month or once weekly. So, amat na pila ni. The longest recorded wedding lasted 91 years and 12 days. Sabi yun, abot sila 19 years. Mabot pa katani. Mabot pa katani, Mama Lu, sir. Sir Bird? 1 year. Couples who spend more than 5 hours a week together compared to average couples have the most successful marriages. So, do you spend 5 hours a week for your couple? So, based on sa survey, no, they have more successful marriages. And then, marriage does more to promote life satisfaction than money or sex. So, mas kongede ay mas makapahalipay gid ang kami niyo on kaysa money or sex. Amen? Agree? So do you know what marriage is? Kabalo taon say kami niyo on. So my second question is, do you understand what marriage is? Sabtan ba na to ang kami niyo on? So now I would like to tell you this, no? Listen, brethren. Si God gave us, God gave marriage to man. Gitagaanta sa Ginoo aning kami niyo on. God gave marriage to us all. Tatanan, you, appeal sa mini-Mitch, no? And God created man woman. So that is male and female. So walay bayot, walay tumboy, He created ang Ginoo. And when He created Adam and Eve, He also gave them marriage. Now, what are some common reasons why people get into a divorce, an annulment, or legal separation? Now, here are some what people say. Ngano nga mo involve sila? Ngano nga mo kuan sila ng separation? So, isa, no, ingon nga, I don't love him like I used to. Wala na magkukigugma sa masawa, so bulag na mi. Dili na ni siya mo akong expect, no, sa una, lutuan ko niya, karon kay dili man di ay mo luto. Second, she's not as attractive as she used to be. Dili na magkukigugma siya guwapa. Ana, tambok na, or maybe nutiguang na, ana. So, daghan na kayo, ana, mostly physical, ano? Dili na Coca-Cola body. And then, I don't have the same feelings anymore. So, wala na spark. Wala na spark. No, sa una, mabilar ko, magsige huna-huna sa iyaha. Karon mabilar ko kay, magsige naglaba, maghugas plato. So, mani siya mga reason, mga major reason why people go into a divorce, no? So, I don't love him anymore. She's not as attractive as she used to be, and I don't have the same feelings anymore. So why is it important to talk about God's purpose in marriage? Ngano importante niya to topic karon because marital problems causes emotional breakdowns, which are very stressful and exhausting. Kapoy yung kayo naaway ba? Kapoy kayo naaway. Makaluyag yun. Di ka ganang kaon. Di ka ganang katulog. Because marital problems happens among non-believers. It happens among believers. And it even happens also among church leaders. Maski sa mga pastors, no, unusual kay they're supposed to officiate weddings, pero sa ila pud gyapon kakahitabo ni siya. Because Satan ambushes marriage. And then Satan attacks everyone. So bisag kinsa, walay kuna, wala gyud paltos, believer and unbeliever, wala exempted. Iyan ang atakon, Buddhist ka, unsa ba na nga religion. So what's the problem here? Problem here is that we have wrong conception about marriage. Sayop ang atong understanding about marriage. Problem here also is we give in to marriage, no? Sulod din ta sa kaminyoon without even consulting God's word. Dili na to basahon ang Bible una unsay kuan, unsay message about sa marriage. And problem here also is that the Christian side, the right side is the silent side. Mao po ni problema dayon kay kita no Christian, say maghilom-hilom lang ta, dili po nando sila advice-an ana ato lang sang palabyon. So in the verses of scripture, no, the book of Genesis, kato tong gibasa kaganina, it tells us about God's purpose of marriage. So Genesis chapter 2 is about the first marriage. Pareha bahin to siya sa kuan, bahin to siya sa una gyud nga kaminyoon, marriage of Adam and Eve. And then Genesis 2 is also about the premise for relationship. It talks about the truth, the real plan and story about marriage. Nga ang kaminyoon, dili ginapili nga kasal lang ta ilawom sa kahoy, ilawom sa kakahoyan, nga ato ding witness kay mga kalanggaman o mga beautiful nga view o, without God in it. Naagin na siya yung premise. No? The problem is, dili pwede na siya because marriage has a premise. So mo nang kinahanglan dyan nga na atay mag-officiate o na mag-witness, na mag-officiate sa iya. Genesis 2 is about God in marriage. So Genesis 2 also talks about no God in marriage. Marriage is not only a public ceremony before witnesses of living and cleaving, but it is a meshing together process with certain godly ingredients. Diba? Ang kaminyon is like a cocktail man na siya. Mura na siya cocktail, lili na siya, mura ka ng imulang hilison ang hilison mo ang kandila, ana. But it is a cocktail, no? It is an amalgamation na siya. Sa kaminyoon, dili gid na dapat mawala ang pagkababae sa babae. Dili sa dapat mawala ang pagkalalaki sa lalaki o ang pagkaginoo sa Ginoo, no? Naagi na siya, magpabilin gina siya. Now, who invented marriage? Of course, no, it's not humans, it's not aliens, it's not the courts, it's not the government. Man did not invent the idea of marriage. God did. Ang Ginoo gyud ang nagbuhat sa marriage. Marriage is not only about signing a piece of paper, no? You might think nga kontrak-kontrak lang ni sila, just like ka na sa Las Vegas, no? Ang ilang marriage, only contract, wala ganit yung solemnity. Pero it's only because of the contract. It's not about that. Marriage is not also about making babies, no? Dili tungod kay naa kay bata, just like sa mga sa Filipino nga family. Minyo na mo, kay nana mo'y anak. Or even sa Filipino family, no? Wala pag ikasal, nanay mga anak. No, it's not about that. Marriage is not also about making money. Nga, mili kag doktora, mili kag lawyer, kay financially, ana, mo imuhang ninyoan. Although, ang uban sab kay koan ka nang, sige minyo ta, kay Kana mo kung single ka, taxes man gud ma-deduct sa imo ha, mas dako. Nga inig maminyo ka na kay Paris, mo lower man imong tax. So nasa iban sa dana. But actually it's not about the money. Marriage is not also loose and lawless, no? Dili na siya loose and lawless. Actually naa gibalaod ang kaminyoon. There are rules in marriage, no? And marriage actually has lots of laws. Sa balay, naay balaod. Di ba? Naamoy balaod, iset. Kamu nga magtiayon. And then sa government, and also it has also laws with God. And marriage should not also be subjected to the state laws. No? The state doesn't have the right nor the competence to regulate a God-given institution. Dapat ang kaminyoon, dili matabunan sa mga balaod sa gobyerno. No? Kana nagbuat ana, kana mga congressman o mga senator, paguli nila sila mga balay, problematic yabong kay sila marriage. It shouldn't be subjected to state and state laws. And marriage should not also be subjected to science. So it cannot be subjected to biology, chemistry, astronomy, or physics. No? Dili na siya dapat makuanan, dili na siya dapat nga madiktahan sa science. No? And then marriage should not also be subjected to liberal philosophy. Okay? Liberal philosophy sa mga universities. Universities means unity of diversities man na siya. Lain-lain nga mga school of thought. Sa mga schools na ba, usahay, dili nagatagaan og dili ang marriage. And even sa mga movies also, no? Hollywood movies, common kayo na mga premarital sex. So marriage is not like that. Now verse 18. So verse 18, then the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him. So it is not good. God said it was good 7 times. One thing was not good because in this case, he said it was very good only after the woman was created. Ikapito, nag-ingon ang Ginoo, no, it was good. Pero the only time that he said that it was very good was when he already created the woman. So these were the times that God said that it was good. So when God created the grasses, the trees, and then the vegetations, God said it was good. So Genesis chapter 1, verse 12. And the earth brought forth grass and herb and yield seed according to its kind, and the tree that yields fruit, whose seed is in itself according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. Pag-create niya sa mga kasagbutan, ang ingon lang niya, it was good. He did not say it was very good. When God also created and accomplished His job making the sun, the stars, and the moon, God said it was good. Grabe, no, gibuhat na niya. Di ba? Amazed kita sa mga planets, even sa sun and the moon. But when God created that, ang gingon lang niya sa Ginoo, it was good. Sabi, no? Amazed kita na. When God created the fishes and the birds, God said it was good. So God created every great sea creatures and every living thing that moves with which the waters abounded according to their kind, every winged bird according to its kind, and God saw that it was good. Ang iyang gingon lang was, it was good. But only after God created man and woman did God say it was very good. So grabe, even day sa universe, no? Although we are in awe of the universe, but when God created the universe, He only said it was good. But when God created man and woman, that's only the time nga niingon siya. So grabe yung kita, in the eyes of God, we really are indeed, no? Treasure yung ta sa iya mata. We really are like hidden pearl. God gave Adam a job before He gave Eve. Now out of the ground, the Lord God had formed every beast of the field and every bird of the heavens and brought them to the man to see what He would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. So before the ay gihatag si Eve, ang first good nga gihatag sa Ginoo sa was a job for Adam. So before marriage, God gave Adam a job before He gave Eve. So job first, no? Before a wife. So if we have friends, or if we have our mga anak na to, atugid sila, even si Nojo, balik-balikan na nanak ko si Nojo, ang anak, sa kaminyon raba, is trabaho sa yun una. No? Unlike sa Filipino family. Kanibang god ang ato, kanibitaw mga premarital na itong relationship. Actually, we inherited that, not from the Americans. Katong sa Clark sa una, sa Pampanga, di ba, daghan kinangabuntisan ato? Daghan sa bepo nilang pakaslan. Ang Amerikano, once na sila mabutisan, ilang magpakaslan. Ang problema kay mga prostitute man sabto, dili magpakasal. Pero kanid yung kultura, ang kanid yung kultura, bitaw nga, premarital sex, mga lalaki makabuntis, dili pakaslan. Actually, ato na na-inherit sa mga Espanyol sa una. Kay sila, makabuntis sila, dili nila pakaslan. Mga Amerikano, actually, mga kuan man sila, mga maayo man sila. Even ang mga native, ginanagya po mga native, no? Magkabuntis, anak niya, dili, kuan. It even also happens among sa mga house helps. Slowly kay mga house help. May mga helper bitaw sa kana mga bag-ong mga helper niya kuan tuwa na din ang mga predator maghulak na din ng mga lalaki diya sa gawa luoy kayo buntisan lang in taon nila dalhon lang sa mga kalibunan. So this is a lesson to single men. Get a job first before you get married. So for us, no, mga single men, we have to teach the young generation. Ansa ma'am? So we have to teach them, no, that marriage should come first. Come think of it. Adam has everything. Naanak ang Adam tanan. So he had a perfect environment, di ba? Guwapo kayong environment niya. Ecologically perfect. All kinds of trees, no smog, no traffic, no mortgages, no taxes. Hassle-free environment, just beautiful mountain and green high mountains. Ang environment ni Adam, kung imagino ni mo, war ka ng klaviria ba, or ka na bitang dahilayan. Wow. Guwapo kayo ang iyahang, kuan, ang iyahang environment. He had also a great job, no? He got to observe animals all day and give them names. Lami kayo ang kinabuhi. Ang kinabuhi ni Adam was only to name animals, no? Mura siya Nat Geo sa itong time. Mura siya si Kim Atienza, or mura siya si Steve Irwin. Ganahan mo sa ginahan ang trabaho? Igo na ka magngalan and you will be earning huge amount. And then, he had fellowship also with his creator, the God of the universe. So, guwapo kayo kinabuhi. Mamit pag yun niya si God. So, he was with God. He wasn't alone in that sense. He knew God and he fellowship with God. So, may imagine no lang mo, mapakita ang Ginoo, it's very beautiful. Guwapo kayo makita every day. It was the Lord. And then, kato siguro nga time, no, whatever questions ni Adam, Lord, unsa man ang nasa universe, in just one click, isuroy niya sa Ginoo. So, katugid nga life ni Adam, that was already heaven on earth. But the problem was, Adam was lonely. Lonely gyapon siya. He was very alone. No? Dili gyud ako. Grabe, no? Dili. Masamta niyo nga. Anong lonely pa mga siya nga? Mao naman ni ato ganing ginapanganduy. Mao naman ganin ni ato ang ginadream. Kanin nga trabaho. Kanin siya nga senaryo. Nga ma-meet ni mo ang Ginoo. Masturyan ni mo ang Ginoo. But still then, Adam... So, Adam was still lonely. So, God's intention in marriage was actually to dispel loneliness. Amo din rason, niyagi, create sa Ginoo ang marriage. It was to dispel loneliness. Ighatag na biyan niya tanan kang Adam. Di ba? That's the icon. Gwapo kayo na siyang illustration. God already gave everything to Adam, but yet Adam was still lonely. So, marriage was designed to solve loneliness. And marriage is God's idea. So ang lalaki no kay kung wala gi kauban ang lalaki mingaw na siya magsige na sa ginuktok. Worst is basig yan testingan tong mga animals ni noon. Murag mo gyud akong gi-imagine ba no nga si Adam ra murag iya kong gi-testingan siguro minsa. Oh, pag-awat siya nga unsa man ning lion nga ga breeding man bisag kinsa sa diyan bridan. Wala pa magdetail. So God designed marriage to take away a fundamental problem of loneliness. So loneliness, gidi ay, mo gidi ay ang premise, ana. It was about loneliness. Now, this is not to give, kaya di ba, gi-invent, gimbinto sa Ginoo ang marriage because of loneliness, dapat na agi-paris, no? But this is not also to give no indignity sa itong mga single. This is nato nga, ato pod silang tagaan. Because the norm is, no? The norm, mo gini siyang norm. What is normal is it's not good for man to be alone. Dili maayo sa lalaki nga. But the exception, there are exceptions. God blesses certain single people to stay single and to devote their lives more intently to the work of God. Naapoy ginabless yun nga masingle. So who are? Sige, who are the singles here?
Mama
Rillette, silang Ma'am Sheila. So how do we treat Mama Rillette and Ma'am Sheila? How do we treat our singles here? Nga niyo na to sila pag-treat. We should honor them. I-honor na to na siya. We should treat them with admiration and respect. Because to be single is a high calling. No, it's hard to be single, but it's made easy to them because God gave that to them. Isod kayo, pero ang Ginoo actually may nagpasayon ana ilang kinabuhi. Nga despite the loneliness, pero gikuan siya. So we have to honor them. No? Di nato sila sulug-sulugon. Nga kinalan, maminyo na juka, ganako na kakidad, and di nato sila sulug-sulugon. Remember ba ya, si Jesus was single, Paul was single, Elijah was single, John the Baptizer. So inginan ni Sab na, kung maminyo na sila, maminyo na si Mama Rilet o si Sheila, kinsay mo puli sa ilahang mga buluhaton. Diba? Because single sila, very mobile na sila. Now, we should also esteem them. Ato silang esteem, no? We should think highly of them. We have to respect them. Never let them feel sorry of themselves, no? And then we have to encourage, dili na ito ipa-feel sila nga luoy kay sila, no? Nagiluoy kay ka, ma'am. Kinahanglan na dyan ka, maminyo, ma'am. Parisa na dyan ka na mo. And then, worst of all, napag yung worst pag yun. Nga, mo man, ang single na siya, nga, babae, babae, mo siya, tumboy, mag na siya. Mo man, ang single na siya, dako na edad, kay bayot, mag na siya, na, di ba, napag yung na.
Juicy, mag ka mo na,
siya kayo nakafocus, ha?
Ano, mag sa limit, mag
nakafocus.
So we should also recognize their gift. Good, no? We have to recognize that wala nagyatag sa atong a gift that's a very special gift for them, so we should accept their gift. No, it is not an accident to be single. Dili na accidente Paul was single, Jesus, Elijah, daghan kay single. So that is why, no, if you have a single friend who wants to have a boyfriend, natay mga single nga friend niya, gusto ko kuan, tagay ko boyfriend, tagay ko kuan kay ila. We have to advise them well. Tagaan nato sila advice, no nga, nindot lang na naay boyfriend kay. Lain ra ba mga single when they look at married people, no, they look at us as happy. Pero ang mga married people, no, when they look at single people, we look at them also as happy or gusto sa mag-single. Ato ko siya kanan nga, sa kaminyoon raba yung ani. Oh, it's not what you... Maraming happy imong tanaw sa moa, pero pag-abot sa imong balay, pag-abot sa imong balay, o oh, mapariha mo anan ni Mama Lu nga biyaan na si Pastor Bernie, matug Amerika. Ma-abroad. So who are single sa to ang church yan? Kinsay pa yung mga single. Mama Rilet, Ma'am Sheila. Rex. Oh, si Rex.
Carlo.
Esther. Oh, dagan kayo.
Si Jude. Kailan siya ABCD.
Si Jude. Kanila silang June kay mga bata pa magud sila, no, di pa kay tamaka kanang makasrog mga judgment sila, pero kaning mga idad-idaran na kay anak magore na nga woman nang single po siya kay bait siguro na siya. Nabito na yung mga nalo. Pero it's a gift ba yun? So now we know na that is how we treat them. That is how we treat them. Atuwa silang i-encourage sa ilang pagka-single. Encourage na ito. Sige lang ma'am, okay naman na nga single ka because you have kuan. Mas mo na siya imong gift. Atuwa na silang kuanan. Now, a bus full of old ugly people had a head-on collision with a truck. So there was this bus path. Yeah. Ang iyang mga pasahero kay mga kuan, mga ugly people. So when they died, pagkamatay nila, God granted all of them one wish. So the first person said, I want to be gorgeous. Pagkamatay nila, tagan sila wish nga i-grantigan. So I want to be gorgeous. Mogi nilang first. I want to be handsome. Now God snapped his finger and it happened. Psh, guwapo na yun. The second person said the same thing and God did the same thing. Ngayon po siya, I want to be gorgeous. Psh. This went on and throughout the group. God noticed the last man in line was laughing hysterically. Puro nag-iisa katao dito nga sige katawa. By the time God got to the last 10 people, the last man was laughing and rolling on the ground. Grabe pa yung kaya nga katawa, kaya kanin yung tumbling-tumbling. When the man's turn came, he laughed and said, so guess what? No, yung ingon sa kang kuan mo, yung wish. Yan ang wish kay, I wish they were ugly again. Sure ko, Pilipino ni. Pinoy yun ni. No, kay Pinoy, di ba anak man, no nga. Basta gani mag-inom ang Pilipino, gusto gini lang kahubog tanan. No? Hubog tanan. Basta gani, pobre sa usa ka kasilinganan, gusto gina, pobre gina tanan, nablagid siya.
Tabla-tabla,
so verse... Uy, apil biya na sa kanat to, sa katong, ato ang DA revolutionary. Nga. Diligyod magkuhan. We have to really change our paradigm. Okay, verse 20, the man gave names, hapit na, the man gave names to all livestock and to the birds of the heavens and to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found a helper for him. So there was not found a helper fit for him. So walay katabang, walay kauban si Adam. Now, a helper fit for him is, so unsa man ang helper fit for him? A helper fit for him is somebody who is comparable to him. So this actually is a mate like him, no? Someone who is very similar. No, not really nga. Actually, dili man kita parihag na ang laki o ang babae, pero generally, di ba, atong ulo na dire, atong kamot na dire. Walay balibo. Walay balibo atong now, atong hitchkwan, walatay ka ng ilong sa elephant. So pare-pareho og structure ni Adam. So a helper fit for him, no, is a helper that will correspond. So this helper is actually a mate that can respond or communicate with him. Yeah, mastorya. Actually, ang ato mga pet, mas ato man ang mag-communicate, pero dili gyud no 100 times gyud ang tao. So that is what God provided. And this helper also, no, is a suitable helper that would make him grow intellectually, no, kana mastorya niya intellectually, mastorya niya bahin sa mga news, ana. This helper also can help him grow spiritually. Ma-Bible study niya, mauban niya, madala niya sa church. This helper also can make him grow physically, di ba? Kanang makaprovide sa itong physical needs. And this helper also, no, is someone also who can provide for us our emotional needs, no, maminaw sa tua, sa tua ang storya niya. Kani siya, nga helper, can also provide emotional, if our emotional needs, nga dili makapasakit sa tua. Mao na siyang original unta, nga dili makapasakit sa tua. And then this helper also, no, is a suitable helper that would also complete us, makakompleto sa ato. Our wife actually is our other half. So ang atong asawa, it's not ako apple, siya bayabas. No, actually ang atong asawa is we are one apple, diri ko nga side, and then ang wife nato is na ao. It's not apple and apple or apple and guava, but one whole apple. She is our companion, no? Siya ato ang kuan. Siya ato ang companion, siya atong kastorya, no? Mao na siya nga kumagabi, siya atong kastorya. Siya mo yato ma-share sa space. Pero lain naman, no? Kaya ang kastorya nga ato na yung companion is ang ato mga cellphone, ana ato mga Netflix, o ang atong asawa, ang atong ka-eye contact or atong asawa sad mo ang iyang ka-eye contact kita, ang iyang ka-eye contact ni noon kay mga Netflix ug mga TikTok. And she is also our counterpart. So just like Mitch, no, she's really my counterpart. Lisod jud kayo kung wala si Mitch pod. A helper. This helper also, no, is someone that we are very hard to live without. So he is, no, our koan. A helper that man can hardly live without. So man is alone without his helper. Now, in the ancient times, and women can thank the Lord for that, sa una, sa panahon pa sa mga Greco, ang mga babae, you know, is only treated as second-class citizen. Wala sila'y bili. In fact, gani, every Greek has to have 3 wives. But thank you, gud, pasalamat kita sa atong time run with the time na sa Bible, sa time na nga, gispread na gid ang Christianity because karon ang women, we take them as our partners. Sa una, dili gid in town partners. Thank you, gud. Yeah, ladies, you really have to thank the Lord Jesus for that. Even getting Islam, they don't treat the women like that. Allowed good sila maminyo og upat. But it's only in Christianity no nga ato yung ginatreat atong asawa. In fact, no, we treat our wives or we should treat our wives as someone who can complete us, make us grow, correspond with us. So uban, wala lang yun. Instrument lang yun na siya. God is protective of marriage relationship, no, because marriage is beautiful. Guwapo gud kay nang kaminyoon. Marriage is wonderful. Marriage is a mystery. 1 + 1 = 1 by ana ang marriage. And marriage grow, no, you won't notice your flaws sa inyong kaminyoon, especially kung close kay mo. Actually, dili gid na nato manotice atong mga flaws, even ang mga white hairs, even ang atong pagtambok, no. So that's the mystery of marriage also. You won't even notice the wrinkles of your wives. Ako din ako mabantayan gani kang Mitch. Mara ako tanaw ni Mitch. Kaya mara 20 years old pa yapon siya. Wow. Honos so niya. And marriage also, no? Marriage as well, no, is very important to God because it's only the institution of marriage also, no, nga gigamit niya for reproduction. No, we grow. Magdagan ang human race. There is synergy as well in marriage. So here are my tips, no? So it will help make a beautiful marriage if we always remember that God brought our wives to us. Always remember this. Di yun nato ni kalimtan. Dili kita mo yung nangita sa tong asawa. Ning duol naman na sila. Ning kalit naman nagabot. Even also you wives. Diba? Ning abot naman nagkalit si Pastor Bernie. Always remember also that God brought you both together. Ang ginuogid mo yung nagdala, nag-uban sa tuwa. Bitaw, no? Mabitaw na, no? I thought sometimes yung mag-sauna, abin ako, nag-ipangita na ako. Even katong mga girlfriends na sauna, even si Mitch, Sharon. Wala mo din na ito ni sila ipangita. Ni abot raman ni sila galit sa to ang kinabuhi. They just come. And vice versa also. Gawas ni Pastor Bern nga si Mama Lumi ng uyap. Yun. So it will also help make a beautiful marriage. No, if we always, no, we remember our wedding. So hinumduman gina to atong wedding. So ato gina ipa-video ang atong wedding. Or i-video na to sa itong mind. Si Mitch, sagsakay sa bus, o na. Okay, kapto man yung bata nga si Punon, magdagandagan sa talad. Si Mitch dito. Okay, college na good ko. Siya, elementary pa. Yeah. Niya ang bus, dito gagi sa ilahang balay.
Natulog mi nga, friend na kuyahan ko, best friend niya na kuyahan ko. So, nasiradan ko sa mua, so dito ko sa ilahang natulog. Lain niya namin
tatulog na sa ilahang. Kasi pa
ako,
din niyo kayo, sorry. Papansin na sa ilahang.
Tanawan, no? Dili na.
Permito, sipa ko tayo ko. Pagkakaduha, hihiyan ko.
So tanawa, no? Dili na gud ni mo ma. Kamu sir bong, di ba? Kuan, sa tay mo story sa TikTok ay si Ma'am Sian. Ah, TikTok. Kamu pas, kamu pas. Mo gyapon, wa gyapon kana expect nga si Ma'am Malo. Daghan ang uyap Ma'am Malo sa una, no? So ang owner gyapon is the neighbor. Kamu Ma'am Jan, mo gyapon Ma'am Jan, wala gyud mo magkuan, wala mo wala mo mag-expect yun, Ana, before. Wala mo makita sa una. Dili ka nagwapo pero na exception lugar exception.
Pero di ba sa hindi ka sa iyo diyan? Wala pa pag new blueberry.
So another also, no, we have to remember our wedding. Namo yung mga videos sa inyo mga wedding. Tanaw-tanaw na siya. And then isa din ano, say kay kanang pangutan ko nang what's the best thing that has happened to your life? Di ba malibog ta nga. Ay, katong treat na mo, tuburakay, ana. Pero, ang the best good nga thing that happened to our lives, ako testimony, kay katujun tayo nakita na ako si Mitch. First, ba? No? Or ka nang, wow, makana dyan ka, oh, kids naman, ni, kukuha ko. Nga, ang mga salesman na to, kay nataranta sila, siya nga, sir, nga, ako ramay ulitaw sila, mga minyo, man. Nga, sir, may maganda doon ako, ana. Oh, wow. Momentay, no? Ang happiest thing, a moment, good kay, that the first time we saw our girlfriend or our wives that time. So to the spouses here, be patient to one another, be gracious to one another, and serve your spouse's emotional needs. So natin mga emotional needs. Okay, we go now to our discussion questions. What is your stand about marriage before and how is it now? What is divorce to you? What protective measures do you do to protect yourself from it? And then if you haven't met your spouse, kani, This is just a theoretical question. No? What kind of life do you think you have now? Oh, grabe kayo. Kaganina sa mosa niya, kung ikaw ka Notch, yung Notch, what if kami si mong mama ang nagdayon? Nabi po si Tubag siya, paligid ka ma-Christian pa.
Oh.
Kasi Tubag. Okay, sige. So, ladies, you group here, diri mo. Stay mo, diri mo, mga ladies. Kami diri ni. Diri ta, mga men. So, 4 minutes each. Ay, by the way, napaday ko yung last. So, my last one also, this is a quote from Peter Buffett. So, si Peter Buffett. Ingon si Peter Buffett, it didn't matter how big our house was, it mattered that there was love in it. Si Peter Buffett,
bahala sa akin sa loving.
Si Peter Buffett, anak ni siya ni Juan, anak ni siya ni Warren Buffett.
Anak ni siya ni
Juan. Youngest son of billionaire investor Warren Buffett. So manang ingon siya nga, it didn't matter how big our house is. So naku, yes, nagbalay. But what matters most is that there was love in it.
Wala na yung part-time. Wala na yung part-time. Wala na yung part-time.